Hey, it's Sarah, and I'm back today to give you 10 verbs you can use when you're writing goals for expressive language. And I hope that these tips will help you when you are writing those goals in those IEP meetings. Number one, increase. So when we're thinking about expressive language, we're looking for increases will increase their length of utterance. It's one I use all the time. Number two, use. I just love this verb because it's functional. The student will use two prepositions in a sentence with a fading model in 4 out of 5 attempts. Number three, name. Student will name 5 words from a category, super functional, and increases their ability to learn vocab words and then use them down the line. Number four, combine. Combining words, especially when you're working with little guys, the combination of words can be really hard. Number five, verbalize. The student will verbalize their feelings using a complete sentence in 4 out of 5 attempts with models or cues, something to that effect.
Side note,
I just want to let you know that I do 4 out of 5 more frequently than I do 8 out of 10, because it can be really hard in a group therapy session to get fully 10 trials. So just keep that in mind. I kind of bring it down. Same thing, it's 80%, but it's 4 out of 5. Number six, answer. Student will answer 4 to 5 why questions after reading a passage with fading models or intermittent models. Models are the key, and as far as I'm concerned, because when we're talking about models, we're actually providing that value as a pathologist. If they can do it without my models and support, they don't need speech therapy.
Mic drop.
Number seven, define. Student will define the word by providing 1 to 2 adjectives to describe it, or 1 to 2 meanings of a multiple meaning word. Defining is such a great verb, especially for those older students. Number eight, describe. Student will describe a common object using 2 characteristics. So many of our students really do lack those that ability to describe. That has to be taught. Number nine, contrast. Student will contrast 2 objects from a category and provide those differences between them verbally. Increases the depth of their vocab knowledge, and also it'll help them in the classroom. And number 10 is compare. Student will compare 2 words and talk about their similarities. I do like to split up similarities and differences because those are really tough for a lot of kids. It's not something you can just lump together, similarities and differences. 10 verbs for you to incorporate in your IEP goals when you're writing expressive language goals. If you would like more freebies to help you when you're navigating that school environment, please go ahead and click the link in the description to join my email list, where I'm emailing useful stuff all the time, and you know you want to be included. So get on it, and I will catch you in the next video. Thanks so much.